Good afternoon, and this is Security Pal speaking. And you thought this record site would be a DJ Audio's file. And then, wow, out of the blue, I can tell you that it's not. This is not a DJ Audio's file. You have been used to it by now. You think that all sites on this vinyl and the vinyls I do is always DJ Audio's files. And suddenly there's this one, and it's not a DJ Audio's file. Can you believe it? Anyway, I've received a lot of letters and even a fax, and on this one have been requests. People have said, can you not release the music to play back Lecture By on itself without you saying things on top? And some of them have said, the things I was saying on top, what was it? And ha, you can have it here. You can have it here. This is the music to play back Lecture By once again, but it's in an international one. Yes. Some of my friends, they wanted to be supervillains of keyboards when they were younger. And if you want to be a keyboard supervillain, you have to... It really takes strange, because you have to perform the kind of music that nobody likes you to perform. So by the time I was performing this music to play back your Lecture By, which is a few years ago, then I was blasting a lot of music that nobody likes. Uncool music to play, like the theme from Pirates of the Caribbean, and Popcorn and whatnot. And we're gonna hear some of it. An old American TV series called Gilligan's Isle, or whatever it was, I can't remember the title. But those kind of TV teams and things that nobody... I mean, with Uncool, as soon as you break into them, you destroy the mood of any party. And then I played a lot of venues which nobody liked as well, like... I mean, which my kind of person should not be performing. Thai restaurants, weddings, things like that. And I had the musical best time of my life, and the most fun part of it was that none of my friends, nobody liked it, and everybody took a stand against what I was doing, which fascinated me quite a bit. If you are a keyboard or synthesizer supervillain, you have to perform with instruments which other keyboard players, the good guys, or the kind of keyboard that they don't like. Like so for example, if they are into Hammond organs, you should perform on the Yamaha Turos series, or for example, a keyboard like a Roland C230. Nobody likes these kind of keyboards, and then you have to play a different kind of music. A lot of there's a Swedish group called Vintergatan, and they play music that musicians like. But if you want to be the keyboard supervillain, you have to perform something else. You have to perform twist the scenario, basically, and perform a kind of keyboard music that nobody likes. And I'm gonna give it to you, and this is gonna work. This is where it's at. I'll spare you for the Pirates of the Caribbean and the Gilligan's Isle, but we are gonna go right in with Popcorn.
understanding Italy, or, I mean, they're literally the author about, the mental about, sensitizing relationship. And I think really it's about the keyboards, really, thank you, Senna, and everybody down in Italy, they're really, really crazy about them keyboards, really. I think it's something Italian about that, that they can play. They're not into modular shit, they're all into sensitizing music and Shang-Chi Starman and the James and all that. They love that. Even the women, we play with Marches, love that.
they all intercape. It gives me like a woman called Marie Louise. We walked out to a jazz show and came back and came down there, and it was supposed to be an organ dream. What we did was like, it was just one organ on stage, and it was just like jazz musicians and all that crap. And basically we were just like, oh, what is this about? And what it was about was like, it was all about the Hammond organ, because all the jazz musicians, they love the Hammond organ, and they're like, yeah, let's do this. And I always thought it was more interesting to try to dig into those instruments that nobody likes really. And it makes sense quite a few instruments that nobody really likes. For example, the Roland is used to have a suit tie. And also, all the instruments like the Yamaha and stuff like that. And it's really cool. And yeah, this kind of music that we've been performing here, that's performed with that.
Classic. really. Like your anger. I mean, I'm quite fed up an anger quiet, really. I don't mind that. I mean, I don't mind. I mean, it's alright. The pirates can fly. That's right, but what's come down to you? You've got to be on the ocean. Put up pirates to make the ocean. Like a Viking, be king. That's the man of the sea.
And they were all doing trance music, and they're really good mates, really. They were down to earth, working class kind of people. I really loved them. And the trance people, they were really good, but they were not like arty and all that. They were probably into drugs and shit. And one of my mates, he had some real trancy people, friends like that. And they were really into trance music in general. And they say that if they went to concerts and the music were boring, they just started to control the live acts. Synthesizers with their stomach because they could control the parameters of a Roland JD-800 with the stomach. Yeah. Yeah, think about that. Anyhow, now it's me time to take you to get a bit beyond reality once again. Yeah, we're done. We'll be right back.
Thank you.